In this video, you will learn how to add users into your Moodle website. Hello everyone. In the last video, we learned how to create a free Moodle website using Genomio. In this video, you are going to learn how to add users in Moodle website. User creation process in Moodle and in Genomio are exactly the same. I'll be using Moodle website to make you understand how to upload users, both individual and bulk upload, in the administrator role. Firstly, it is important to understand that every user needs to create an account first before they can enroll in any of your courses. Moodle calls this sign-up process as authentication. So everyone who has created an account is considered as an authenticated user. To get started, let's log in to our Moodle website, and then on the left-hand side menu panel, you will see Site Administration. Click on Site Administration and then click on the User tab. Under User tab, you will see an option Add a New User. So as I already mentioned, there are two ways to upload users. You can either upload individually or you can bulk upload. So firstly, I'm gonna show how you can upload users individually. So let's click on Add a New User. It starts with the username up here. Then choose an authentication method. You don't have to change manual accounts over here. The suspend account option is not for us right now. You can use this for existing users to suspend their account so that they can't log in anymore to your site. Now you can tick this box if you like, which automatically creates a password that is sent to the user's email address once you have finished setting up their account. Alternatively, you can also create a password for them by typing over here. So there are some rules for creating a password. You can read them out and create a password. Now, if you choose to create your own password, the users won't automatically get notified that an account has been created for them. So you would have to go ahead and send an email to the user with the link to your Moodle website and the password you have created. Again, the next tick box will force the user to change the password on their next login. And then you just have to provide the first name, surname, and email address. These are the mandatory fields. And you can add all these other information that you might find important for users to have. You can even upload a user picture if you have one. But all these details can be added and edited by the user later anyway. So you don't have to worry too much. Now let's scroll all the way down and then click on Create User. Now again, if you haven't clicked automatically generate the password, you will now have to send an email to the user, tell them that an account has been created so that they can log in for the first time. Once you created the account for the user, you'll find the user in the users list. So what we just created is what Moodle calls an authenticated user. This user simply has an account on your Moodle site but is not a student yet. To become a student, the user would have to enroll in a course on your site. So this is how you can enroll users individually into your Moodle website. Now let's see how you can enroll many users at the same time using an Excel sheet. So this time we will create accounts for many users in one go. So the first thing you have to do is enter data on an Excel sheet or on Google Sheet. So I'm opening a fresh Google Sheet over here, and then we are going to provide four account details in different columns. The first column contains username, the second column is first name, the third one is last name, and the fourth column is email. Please make sure that all these information are exactly spelled like I show you over here. Otherwise, Moodle won't be able to identify the information and put the users in the right spot. All you have to do now is put information of the users you want to upload in the rows below. I'm going to enter username, first name, last name, and an email ID for demo purpose. Next is password. If you don't have a password column in your Excel sheet, that is fine. Moodle will automatically generate a password for each user that you put in the Excel sheet and will send it to their email address once we upload the file to our Moodle site. This is a very good option in my opinion. So you can just leave these four columns and don't have to worry about the password. But if you want to provide users with your own password, you would have to create a password column. So we would just name this column here password. And then down in the cells below, you would insert the password that you want each user to have. If you provide your own password this way, users won't receive an email once their account is created. So you would have to send them an email manually, including the password, so that they can log in for the first time. I didn't want to do that. I want Moodle to create passwords for me and automatically send them out in emails. So I'm just deleting this password column. By now, you have certainly realized that all these pieces of information stand for all the different sections in the user's account details. So, you could provide a lot more details if you like. For example, if you want to identify the country of a user, you just create a new column that says country and then name the country of the user in the cells below. Anyway, I don't want this information as users can edit later themselves. So let's discover a few more handy options that you have when creating accounts through Excel sheets. For example, you can straight away enroll users in existing courses on your site. All you have to do again is create a new column and name it Course 1, which creates a course information. And then you create one more column and name it Role 1, which determines the role that the user should have in the course. And after this, you have to provide the course short name of the existing course that you want the user to be enrolled in. Let me just quickly show you what the short name of the course is so that you don't get confused. You have to go to one of your courses and the short name is a one over here. It's not the full name up here. So in my case, that would be GTM. And that's what I'm gonna put in the course 1 column. Once you have done that, don't forget to name the role the users should have in that course. You just go to the role 1 column and say student, because this is the role I want to have in course 1. Let's now go one step further, and you could even add the users into existing groups of that course. Again, you would have to create another column and name it group 1. In the cells below, you would then provide the name of the existing group of the course. If you don't have a group in the course yet, you can still create a column group 1 and then provide a group name that you want for a group to be created. So this would then create a group within the course and directly put the users in that group. By the way, the same principle also goes for cohorts. We can easily add our users to existing cohorts in your Moodle site. So create another column and name it Cohort 1. In the cells of the column, we have to provide the ID of the cohort that you want users to be added, not the name of the cohort. And if you haven't created any cohorts yet, you can just provide a random ID here, and when you upload the file, it will automatically create the new cohort with the ID that is provided. So basically, in this authentication process, you can sign users up, enroll them into courses, add them to course groups, and add them to cohorts. But that's just a quick side info. We'll be doing an entire video on how to enroll students into your courses. So I'm just deleting the last couple of columns, and that's it. Now you just have to provide the username, first name, last name, and email address of each user you want to create an account for in the different roles, just like I did here. Now that we have completed our sheet, we have to save it, and that's a very important part. Now don't save it like you would usually do with an Excel file with the ending XLS or XLSX. You want to save it as a CSV file because this is working way better with Moodle. Click on it and save it as you usually do. Now that we have created our files, let's go to our Moodle website and then go to Site Administration, click on Users tab, and then over here you will see an option Upload Users. Click on it and then upload the CSV file. Click on Choose File and then click on Upload a File. Again click on Choose File and select the file from your desktop and then finally click on Upload this file. You don't have to change any options below and then click on Upload Users. Now you can see a preview of users that you're going to upload. Now below in the settings, you can click on Upload Type and there are four options. The first one is to add new only and skip the existing users. The second one is to add all, append number to usernames if needed. And then the third one is add new and update existing users. And the fourth one is update existing users only. So the best option here is add new only and skip existing users. I'm selecting that. And then in new user password, I haven't given any column for password. So I'm going to choose create password if needed and send via email. And then you don't have to change any other options. Just scroll down and click on upload users. And finally, all the users are uploaded and results are shown. So I hope you understood how you can upload users individually as well as in bulk to your Moodle website. See you in the next video. Thank you for watching.